A few months ago, our Ford Model A mail truck was invited to appear at a very special event. The Great American Stamp Show, co-hosted by the American Philatelic Society, the American Topical Association, and the American First Day Cover Society. You never heard of any of them? Well, neither had I. But something you may not have known about Model A expert Robert Gimmerin, he's also a stamp expert. He collects stamps, has been doing so pretty much his whole life. In fact, one whole room of his house is dedicated to nothing but stamp collections. So maybe that kind of ties things in for those of you that were trying to put two and two together of why he would want a mail truck so bad. Well, now it probably all fits in. So they wanted his mail truck to be a centerpiece of a display right in the middle of the convention, pretty much front and center showpiece. The mail truck runs so quiet, I had to really boost the audio of this clip so you could hear it start.
How's your drive?
So good.
Always check your mirrors before backing up. At least that's what I was always taught. So here we are finally unloading the mail truck and the back doors at the Sacramento Convention Center, also known as the Golden One Convention Center, where it was going to live for the next 4 days and be oogled by all the public. I have to confess, I get a little bit nervous every time I drive the mail truck, mostly because it's such an interesting piece of history, but also partially because this thing's a masterpiece, and I don't want to be the one to prang it. Oh look, it's my friend David's finger. I'm not just honking the horn to be cute. There literally is people just walking right out in front of me. Okay, true confessions, when what I should have been thinking right now is, oh my gosh, I hope I don't run over anybody. No, what I was really thinking right now was, I wonder if this is the first Model A mail truck ever to drive indoors on carpet. Seriously, that's what I was thinking. I had to really crank up the audio on these clips just so you could hear it run, but it was way too quiet. All right, got it parked. Time to cue the Benny Hill montage and get it cleaned up. So as you can imagine, at any stamp show, the United States Postal Service is pretty much center stage, and our mail truck was center stage of the center stage.
We're here at the International Stamp Show in Sacramento, California. This is Betty Brown. For those of you who don't know, Betty is the head of manufacturing for the United States Postal Service. So if you have a stamp, Betty saw it first. So Betty, this is the Pony Cars release for stamps. So why Pony Cars?
They go through Citizen Stamp Advisory as a suggestion. And then they approve it, they approve the designs and all the concepts, then art directors begin their work to make it into fruition for a postage stamp.
That's awesome. So from the idea being pitched to you to actual production, how long does that take?
Usually you have to make the suggestion 2 to 3 years. It has to go through a legal process, it has to go through all kinds of approval, and then once stamp development works with the art directors, they get the art to us and we start working with the printers, and 3 to 4 months we've got stamps.
And then we could do a stamp of the mail truck then, right?
Yes, put your suggestion into the Citizen Stamp Advisory Committee.
Thank you so much, Betty. So nice to meet you.
You too.
Royalty, Betty Brown from the United States Postal Service.
Thanks.
It's about 10 minutes to 4. They told us originally that we could leave the cars here until tomorrow and just get them out at our convenience, but then we found out earlier today, nope, We got to have the cars out by 4 o'clock, which means we had to be here before 3:30 to get our stuff, get ready, and have the cars out. So they changed their mind. I guess they got something else going on here this weekend or something. I don't know. Those of you who don't know, backing up a Ford Model A mail truck is impossible to do without leaning out the truck. You cannot see behind you at all if you're inside the truck. Especially nerve-wracking to do indoors when people are just walking around without even looking where they're going. You definitely need helpers spotting for you when you do this.
We would ask that anybody just attending the show please exit the show floor. Any of those who are not sort of either dealers or exhibitors, we would ask that you would exit.
So here's a clip without the sound boosted. You can't even hear the mail truck running. That's why you have to toot the horn once in a while, just so people know you're coming, because they literally cannot hear you coming and will walk right out in front of you. So because of the short notice of having to get the vehicles out, the plan was to drive the Ford Model A mail truck over to the California Auto Museum and leave it there for a while until I can get around to coming up back to Sacramento with the trailer and load it up and haul it home and everything. So for right now, I'm just going to enjoy this. I'm driving a 1929 Ford Model A mail truck through downtown Sacramento, California. How awesome is this? Luckily, that stoplight there lasted long enough. I was able to get my camera hat out, mount the camera into it, and start the recording and put the hat on. So you'll get to see what it looks like from my point of view. It was about a mile of driving through downtown Sacramento through stop-and-go traffic until I got out to the west side into West Sacramento and headed towards the California Auto Museum. Out here, it was smooth sailing. In case you're wondering what that rattling sound is, it's the sliding door inside the mail truck that separates the driving area from the cargo area in the back. The door has rollers that it's hanging on and they kind of rattle a little bit. No big deal. That's David Frank and Robert Gimran up there in that red convertible Camaro that belongs to the museum that just pulled up ahead. I'm just going to follow them in.
Job, Bessie.
These guys had just walked out of the museum and they're like, wait a minute, is that the Model A mail truck from YouTube? Are you the YouTube guy? It's like, the Model A mail truck just gets recognized everywhere it goes.
Made it.
at this RPM, you can really hear that inside sliding door rattling around.
You don't want to. I mean, how many cars can I possibly hit? So.
How can I count the ways?
Yeah, let's see what happens here.
So, funny story, one of the people visiting the museum as a guest at the time the mail truck rolled in instantly recognized the mail truck and came to me and wanted to take a picture with me.
Dangerous driver.
And I said, hey, I'll do better than that.
Down there?
How about you jump in the mail truck and hold my camera for me? I'll give you a ride in the mail truck and a picture. The guy almost peed himself. He was like, I was so happy. So, see, no big deal. You can make someone happy just by plopping them in your Model A and saying, hey, let's go for a short ride. That's all it takes. Model A's make people happy.
How much room we got there? If I do that, I'm gonna end up buying an Imperial here. Okay. Coming over.
We were wondering how they got these cars in.
Remember how I said people just walk right in front of you?
I wouldn't walk in front of me driving something. That guy was living dangerous.
All right, here comes Double Jeopardy. Remember how I said you can't back a Model A mail truck up without leaning outside? All right, keeping that in mind, you cannot see behind you, and now I'm backing up around a lot of very rare, expensive museum cars. What could possibly go wrong?
How am I doing back there? How are we doing?
You're going to foot clear.
Okay,
so
good.
You can kind of scoot over and then you can just scoot over a little bit.
All right. I'm relying on you guys for this.
No problem. You're not going to believe how I did the death. You got
it. Are we straight?
Straight back. To your left a little bit. Come on back.
I'm going to stop, get everything out.
Come on back. That's a little bit.
Hold it.
Right there.
Oh, look at me, how sweaty I am. Not that I was nervous or anything.
Not at all.
Okay, so just got the mail truck parked and in its spot. It's going to be on display here at the California Auto Museum for, I don't know, probably a couple weeks. So check this out. If you've ever wanted to see our Model A mail truck, now's your chance. It is on display in public here at the California Auto Museum, 2200 Front Street, Sacramento, California. It's going to be on display here until I have time to take it home. So anyway, you can come see our Ford mail truck. What's really interesting is it's right across the row from the other mail truck that's here at the museum. That one is 10344. This one obviously 10387. So this one's a tiny bit newer. Anyway, again, our mail truck on display. You can come check it out here at the California Auto Museum, 2200 Front Street in Sacramento. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll catch you on the next video. Huge thank you going out to the California Auto Museum for letting us keep our Model A mail truck there until it's convenient to go get it, and for hooking us up for having it on display at the International Stamp Show. Please check them out, calautomuseum.org.